In the early afternoon of December 4th, 2007, it was a cold yet relatively quiet rainy day at the scenic Chehalis Lake. It was 1:36 p.m. and due to the time of year, what would otherwise be a lake frequented by fishermen and campers was completely devoid of human activity. Suddenly, the light noise of falling rain was shattered by a loud roar which became audible, being specifically caused by a section of the mountainside east of Mount Ora collapsing all at once in a massive landslide. Moving at a speed of 134.2 miles per hour or 216 kilometers per hour, the 3 million cubic meters of rock only took 15 seconds for this landslide to strike the northwestern end of Chehalis Lake. Quickly displacing large volumes of water, the cold lake water lurched upwards, forming a towering wave. A large tsunami had just been generated, which peaked in height at 38 meters or 125 feet and seemingly towered over every fully grown large conifer tree near the lake's shoreline. As this massive wave advanced across Chehalis Lake at a speed of 59 miles per hour or 95 kilometers per hour, it only took 30 seconds for a 38 meter high wave to crash against the first part of its eastern shoreline. Continuing onwards, it took another 15 seconds to reach the northernmost point of the lake and another 15 seconds after that for the wave to run half a kilometer up the Chehalis River. Across the next 3.25 minutes, this massive wave advanced further from its source, striking down large swaths of coniferous trees that lined the valley walls, sweeping them away by the thousands. It then reached the southern end of the lake, partially surging over the downstream portion of Chehalis River and traveling another 650 meters. Across the next 30 minutes, via what is known as a sage, waves rocked back and forth across the boundaries of the 8.8 kilometer or 5.5 mile long Chehalis Lake, almost as if the lake was a giant bathtub. Despite the extent of the damage which occurred, as 3 campsites, a boat launch point, and 10,000 trees had been washed away or destroyed, thankfully no one was killed. This can be owed largely to the time of year, since it was quite cold in December, with this making recreational activities around the lake unfavorable. However, the floating logs of the thousands of aforementioned trees slowly drifted to the south, eventually forming a logjam that acted much like a beaver dam. As a result, this logjam was at risk for collapsing all at once and generating an outburst flood that could harm communities downriver. This risk was thankfully later removed via following several month-long task of removing the debris blocking the river's path. While very little of the trimling which marks the high point the tsunami wave reached has since recovered, some vegetation in select areas has repopulated some of the region. So, why did this landslide and tsunami occur? Generally speaking, when events like these occur in Alaska or Canada, the culprit is almost always the same: retreating glaciers no longer holding up an unstable rock face which they were holding in place beforehand. And yet, this is not the case here, as no very close glaciers are present which recently retreated, with this glacially carved valley having become glacier-free around 10,500 years ago. Instead, there strangely does not appear to be a singular reason why this collapse occurred. However, this region of southern British Columbia has produced other recent major landslides largely due to its common steep and rugged topography, with another example being the Hope Slide in 1965. Yet, looking back at ground imagery before the major collapse happened at Chehalis Lake, there was a series of extensional cracks which indicated that a slow landslide had already been ongoing for some time, albeit unnoticed. The movement of this slope then accelerated until finally the heaviest daily rainfall in 13 months occurred, lubricating the landslide block and causing a 40-meter section of ground to collapse into Chehalis Lake. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.